the Bank of England is issuing new banknotes, beginning with a £5 note, and they're made of plastic, and there have been all sorts of advertisements that you can't break them. I felt immediately challenged, and I had the idea if we froze it with liquid nitrogen, the strands of the polymer would be frozen rigid, and you may be able to break it, hitting it with a hammer. So I gave Neil several of my own £5 notes. You can't spend university money on things like this. And he had great pleasure trying to break the professor's banknotes. And it worked. He managed to smash one, but it took several attempts. You had to get the orientation just right and hit it just in the right way, and then it broke into two or three pieces. Unfortunately, he lost one of the pieces, so I couldn't glue it together and spend the note, so it's a souvenir. Incidentally, it's not illegal to break the notes, though it's illegal to draw pictures on Her Majesty's face. But Neil felt that this wasn't really quite exciting enough, so he decided to put this in his special supply of fuming nitric acid. It's a bit old, so it's gone brown, so it may be even better. Fuming nitric acid, and there's several sorts, and I'm not sure what Neil's type was particularly, but essentially it's a mixture of pure nitric acid, or nearly pure nitric acid, with N2O4 dinitrogen tetroxide added to it. And N2O4 itself can dissociate into NO2, so it's quite a witch's brew, or perhaps I should say wizard's brew in case of Neil. It is well known as being a very powerful cleaning agent. If you can't get muck off your glassware, the last resort is fuming nitric acid. Neil's hypothesis was that he could completely dissolve it. It would just disappear and he could have a solution of a £5 note. What happened was actually much more exciting. That when he put it in, the Queen's face quickly faded. When he took it out, there was some of the writing and stuff still left. But it just brushed off quite easily. And what he was left with, to all our surprise, was a completely transparent piece of plastic, exactly the same size that he started with.
Yeah, lovely.
I gave this sample to one of my students who ran an infrared spectrum and showed that it was polypropylene. This is the plastic made from propene. When it says on the internet these are made from polypropylene, they're right. It's really fun. I now show this to people and say what you think it is, and they have no idea. You can see that we did a proper experiment in the sense that we had a control. I insisted that they also used one of the old paper notes. The Queen didn't fade as much on the paper note, but when they'd taken it out and dried it, it was interesting that the note had gained really quite a lot of weight. And this was absolutely consistent with my idea that the fuming nitric acid might nitrate the cellulose of the paper. This is adding NO2 groups to the paper. And nitrated paper burns very much better than ordinary paper. It's used by magicians and conjurers. And it's the basis, in fact, of gun cotton, which is used as an explosive. It went with a real whoosh. And what was particularly interesting is that it burned without any ash at all. It just disappeared. And the reason for this is that with the NO2 groups, you have enough oxygen in the note to make it burn to completion. So we have a really nice farewell for the old paper banknote. It just disappears into thin air. I must stress that we've done this in the interests of science and because we think it's important and interesting experiment. But on the other hand, we are destroying banknotes, and so we feel that it's only right that we've given an equal amount of money to charity to show that we don't really want to destroy money just for the sake of it. I should say to you that if you want to repeat these experiments, there are probably cheaper ways than doing it than using banknotes.